Beloved in Christ, the three readings for our reflection this Sunday are from Jeremiah 23:1 to 6, Ephesians 2:13 to 18, and Mark chapter 6:30 to 34. In the first reading, the prophet Jeremiah used the image of a shepherd to describe the leaders of the house of Israel, who had the responsibility of caring for God's people. He condemned the attitude of the political leaders of his time as bad shepherds who were leading the people to destruction. They could not take good care of the sheep that God entrusted to their care. They did not attend to the sheep. Instead, they scattered them and drove them away because of their bad leadership and system failure. God said he will punish the bad shepherds and set shepherd over his flock who will care for them. The prophet Jeremiah, speaking on behalf of God, promised the people a right king who will take care of them, a leader from the house of David who will truly be a shepherd to God's people, a shepherd who will administer justice and execute righteousness in the land. This is a message of hope, of restoration and redemption of God's people. Dear brothers and sisters, the gospel passage of today identifies this promised shepherd with Jesus Christ. He is the true Davidic king who comes to find and save the lost sheep of God. And so today we celebrate Christ, Jesus, the true King, a compassionate shepherd who redeems and restores his people to the Father, the shepherd who leads us to greener pastures, protects us, comforts us, and will not make us want anything, as the responsorial psalm from Psalm 23 tells us. Jesus, the shepherd who has brought us from far and reconciled us to God, our peace, as we also read from the second reading of today. Jesus indeed is the good shepherd who never relents in his task of caring for the sheep entrusted to him by God, and will sacrifice all that it takes for them to feel comfort and peace for their sake. In the gospel, when Jesus and his disciples had traveled to go to a lonely place to rest, and he saw a vast crowd who were like sheep without a shepherd, he had pity on them and cared for them. If Jesus had rejected them, they will not know where to turn to, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. They will only scatter. They will go with their problems and fall victim to some wicked, hungry wolves who will take advantage of them. Indeed, Jesus is the shepherd who gathers God's scattered sheep and attends to them. As a good shepherd, Jesus will not rest until our souls and our land is completely healed and restored to his Father. This is why he had to terminate his vacation, his rest, in order to attend to the crowd. Dearly beloved in Christ, Jesus likewise attends to us when we are desperate and look helpless like abandoned sheep. As a compassionate and wise king, Jesus knows our situation. He is doing something about it and will not rest until we are redeemed and restored to God, until we have our comfort and peace. He does not keep quiet over our situation at all. He sees and knows that we have been abandoned by negligent of those who should know better and take care of our situation. We also have a shepherding role to play over those entrusted to our care as priests, over parishioners, church counselors, over God's faithful, societal leaders, over members of your societies and groups, parents, over your children, family heads, over your family members, teachers, over your students, etc. How do we take care of those entrusted to our care? Do we attend to them wisely as shepherds are supposed to do for their sheep? Do we take good care of them? Are they secured and safe with us, or we lead them astray? Do we provide and sacrifice for them? Today, if Jeremiah were to be here, what will he say about us who have responsibility over others and how we handle those entrusted to our care? Beloved family members of God, let us pray for the grace to work for justice and righteousness as leaders and people entrusted with various forms of responsibilities in our church, in our communities, in our societies, families, workplaces, and wherever we encounter people. May God bless and guide us to fulfill His will wherever we find ourselves. Amen. Have a blessed week. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and share my homily with others. Stay blessed.